What's up, Sailor Senshi? I'm Sailor Snubs. Welcome to my YouTube channel all about Sailor Moon news and merch reviews. And today I have books upon books upon books, and it's so exciting. I actually have three books that I wanted to show you. Two are mangas, and one is an art book that I have signed from a Sailor Moon artist. How cool is that? That is really freaking cool. So this is like the only Sailor Moon autographed item that I have in my presence, and I'm going to hold on to it dearly because it means so much to me. I love it. So why don't we hop straight into these items and I will tell you all about them. So the first item that I received is this wonderful art book. This is by Marco Albiro. I hope that I'm saying that correctly. He is an Italian manga artist who has been signed on with a ton of different shows, different anime, as you can tell from this picture on the front of his art book. So we see a lot of these I don't even recognize, so I couldn't really tell you anything about them, honestly, but I was very interested in the fact that he does a lot of Sailor Moon art for promotional materials, for the DVD covers and Blu-ray covers. He does so much art for the show. There are tons of times that I have followed his work on Instagram, and he does tons of Instagram stories where he will post some kind of merchandise that's now available at Box Lunch or on Right Stuff Anime or on Amazon or just promotional stuff from Japan. And he'll be like, hashtag I drew it. And I'm like, that is so amazing. This guy is very successful, and I'm really, really proud to be an owner of something that he has done, especially since he signed it for me. So it says to Shannon, Marco Albiro, and then it has his adorable little signature chibi face. So I love how cute that is. So I'm not going to show you the entire art book because there are a lot of pages in here, but to give you a little bit of history about Marco's work, he has been working in the manga and artist type of industry for decades. I know that he started working with Sailor Moon, I think back when it was republished for like the Crystal campaigns and stuff, and when they started doing the 25th anniversary stuff. So I think that happened back in, let's see, 2009 is when he started working with Sailor Moon. So let's see, the international relaunch of the anime. He made the drawings of the international style guide for the series, Sailor Moon, R, S, Supers, Sailor Star, and then Backstage. So the copyright is for Backstage Toy Animation and Naoko Takeuchi. So some of his other work includes, let's see, Tokyo Mew Mew. I think Dragon Ball is on here, Dragon Ball Z. There is Spider Writers, Totally Spies, I've heard of that one. Mega Slot, Pokemon E Dragon Ball Dance Compilation, My Virtual Boy, Doki Doki Magazine, let's see, Star Wars. He's done work with Star Wars. That's pretty cool. All sorts of things. So I'm sure that there's plenty in here that you would recognize if you look through the art book. So the art book does include a whole bunch of different art that he's done for all of his different series. Like here's a picture for Sailor Moon that he has done in a very manga style. Here's some super kawaii art for Twin Princess and Killary. I've never heard of that, but it looks really cute. And if I move on to around the center of the art book, he has several pages dedicated to Sailor Moon. So for example, here's the art for E2046, which is a manufacturer that does a bunch of Sailor Moon figures. They are not necessarily licensed figures, but E2046 does some amazing work. And this was a Sailor Princess idea that he did for them, which was really cool. He also has some beautiful work of Sailor V located in this book, which I thought was gorgeous, especially with like the rainbow light that's around her and her eyes glinting. There's a lot of different colors going on, which is something that I really appreciate in his work. And then we have some awesome art that he has done, and this is not even half of the ones of Sailor Moon that I'm showing you, but here is some awesome art that he has done of all of the Sailor Senshi as Sailor Scouts with Sailor Cosmos at the front. Very smart. I really like his art drawing here. So it's very beautiful. And they're all Sailor Stars, which is cool. And then this one with a racy Mamoru Chiba in the background. So if you buy one of these art books, which you can get through his Instagram, you can contact him and ask him to send you one. All you have to pay for is shipping plus the fee for the book, which is fairly priced, especially since he will sign it for free, which is awesome. I will mention there is some racier art in here. This is not even like the half of it, but there is definitely some more racier things that you can see in this book, none of which have to do with Sailor Moon, but some of his other work you can definitely see in here. It's a really gorgeous art book. Even if you're just into Sailor Moon, you can definitely appreciate all of the work that he's put into all the different shows that he's been signed on with. Like, seriously, how beautiful is that? Like, what is this from? Hayael? Imamaya? I don't even know how to say that, but it's so pretty. Like, look at all the different colors and all of the different shiny details that he's put into these outfits. Like, seriously, beautiful, beautiful art. So thank you so much to Marco Albiro for sending me his art book. I love it. It is definitely going onto a special space in my backdrop here on my collector shelf. Marco was also really kind and sent over a whole bunch of different art prints that he's done too. So here's one with Arya from Game of Thrones. Please no spoilers, but I love this art print. It is so pretty. He also sent over some postcards. So we have this promotional material for Witch and there's promotional material for a few other shows, including a Sailor Moon postcard, which I love. And I also got his business card. So I won't show you the back of it. It has his phone number on it and stuff like that. But his business card looks like this. So I will put Marco's Instagram information down below in case you're interested in contacting him and getting one of your own art books. I just love the fact that he signed it and he is one of the licensed artists for Sailor Moon, especially since the Sailor Moon relaunch that happened earlier this decade, which I absolutely adore. So I thought it was a really cool piece of history and I'm so happy that I'm owning one of these books. Okay, so the next ones aren't necessarily going to take as long for that description, but these are manga. So first off, these are from Right Stuff Anime and I really like how they package their mangas because it's way better than Amazon. So I had actually purchased this Eternal edition of the manga from Amazon, but it was all dinged up. It looked terrible. So I shipped it back to Amazon and then I repurchased it from Right Stuff Anime. Now their prices are not as competitive as Amazon's prices. So if you want to save a buck and you don't care about the quality, then you might want to purchase from Amazon. However, if you care about quality, if you're a collector, then you probably want to purchase from Right Stuff Anime instead because they took a lot of care into packaging these items so that they don't get dinged up. So here I have Eternal Edition of the Sailor Moon manga. This is number 3, which features Sailor Mars on the front and is absolutely gorgeous. On the back of it, of course, we have Sailor Mars's silhouette and it says Pretty Guardian Sailor Moon Naoko Takeuchi. And it gives you the information up at the top saying the price, which is usually USA $27.99. for this very, very large version of the comic. If you're curious which chapters are included in here, the contents are Act 15, which includes Invasion Sailor Mars, Act 16, Abduction Sailor Mercury, Act 17, which is Secrecy Sailor Jupiter, Act 18, Aggression Sailor Venus, Act 19, Time Warp Sailor Pluto, Act 20, which is Crystal Tokyo King Endymion, and then Act 21, Confusion Nemesis. So this is a very important book in the series. We also have a whole bunch of color pages that are included, just like the previous ones in the internal editions, and the translations are brand new with these as well. So these, I would say, are the best yet as far as the translations go. The pages are a little bit more thick, and they are a lot bigger, so you do end up with a little bit extra art at the edges compared to the smaller versions of these same exact mangas, which ended up being cut off a little bit at the edges. I adore the color pages that are in these Eternal editions of the mangas, and if you are curious about the sizing on these, yes, these are the largest versions of the manga that you can currently get, and compared to the Japanese editions of the most recent ones, these are larger. So this is the biggest edition that you can get, and these are my absolute favorite version of them, even though I like to collect every single version of them. So that was number 3. I also got number 4, which features Sailor Jupiter on the front of it. So this one is also an Eternal Edition manga. This one includes acts 22 through 26, and then it also has Chibiusa's Picture Diary Chapter 1, Beware of the Transfer Student, and Casablanca Memory. So we have everything from Nemesis to Wiseman to Black Lady, then there's Confrontation Death Phantom, Rebirth Never Ending, and then you get the Picture Diary and Casablanca Memory as like short stories at the very end. So Casablanca Memory, I believe, is a story about Sailor Mars. Yes, it is. And then the Picture Diary is a Chibiusa short story at the end of this one. And both of those are really, really cute and highly recommend for a read. So I believe number 5 is supposed to be coming out in the next few months for the Eternal Editions. So I'm definitely gonna collect all of them, and I'm really excited to add them all to my collection, because they are so beautiful. Well worth a read, especially if you haven't read them in several years like I had. So it's definitely worth it to like just sit down with these, take a read, and just have a day where you just read Sailor Moon manga. It's just totally worth it, especially if you love these stories as much as I do. So that is everything as far as my new books that I'm adding to my collection. Let me know if you have any questions. I would love to answer them down below as usual. And don't forget to subscribe and like all the videos on this YouTube channel. Thank you so much for your support. I really appreciate it. And as always, I'm Sailor Snubs, and I will see you in another video very shortly. Jenny!